everybody. I'm Ebony. This is Ebony's Creativity. Thank you so much for joining me here on my channel. Now, normally I do chit-chat videos, DIY videos, and flipping furniture. But today I'm going to try to make a new type of video or a different type of video. What had happened was my fan in my bathroom downstairs, my guest bathroom, has gone out, I guess. Really, it sounds like you're in the Indy 500 on the pit crew when you turn it on. It's already been taken down, so I can't show you how it sounds, but trust me, it would probably bust your eardrum if I did try. But I read online that you can replace the motor in it. And instead of trying to get a whole new assembly, I figured I would try to replace the motor first. Now, this house is very old. My house is 100 years old. So things are, you know, break or wear over time. And it still works, but it's just too loud, and I don't want to be embarrassed. Got my guests over here. They're trying to do their number two in peace. They cut on the fan thinking they're going to air it out, and it sounds like Daytona Speedway. I can't set anybody up like that. So I thought it'd be interesting to try and film it to see if I'm able to successfully install the new motor and put the fan back together. I had someone else take it down, so I don't even know how it looked when it was up there before. I've never tried to do this before. I have absolutely no experience. So let's see if I can do it. The worst that can happen is that I'll mess it up and then I have to hire someone, but it seems pretty straightforward. I ordered the new motor off Amazon, and here is the old assembly here. So it is extremely dirty. And here's the cover, which is also extremely dirty. So I'm going to start out by cleaning all these pieces, and then I'll be able to lift it over my head without all the dirt falling on me. I mean, ugh. I'm gonna clean out the part that's in the hole that's in the ceiling, and I can show you that. That's where this goes, so it seems pretty straightforward, but I've never done this before. I really don't like messing with electrical stuff, but hey, why not try it? So I'm going to get everything cleaned up, and then I will be back to show you the cleaned parts and to attempt to put it all together. Next, I'm going to try to free the motor out of this setup by removing these two bolts. Here I'm just fidgeting and struggling, trying to see how to take this apart without breaking anything.
Wait a minute. Oh snap! Okay, let's see. That's for the pin. Oh snap! Okay, cooking with oil now. Okay, so now what? Piece still has to come off. Don't know how, but. Messing with it. Oh shoot. Okay then.
Here I'm just fidgeting around trying to see exactly how these pieces fit together. So after trying to dry fit the pieces together, I see that I'm going to have to remove these two bolts and it took me a while to get these off. They are rusted into place and they were stubborn. You'll see me trying a couple different methods here to get it off, but thank God eventually I was able to remove it. There are two black screws here that I think need to come off, but I'm not quite sure, and I'm not quite sure how to remove them either. So I'm just going to try to rig this up without removing that. So you'll see me reusing this one of the screws that was originally on this, and then I went to get a new screw for the other side because one of them was kind of rusty and stubborn. So yeah, I just put everything back together. And then next, you will see me fidgeting with the fan piece. I wanted to be very gentle with this thing because this motor was very overpriced and I didn't want to break anything. Like I said, I did not take this down myself and I did not know the correct way to put it back up. So now you will see me trying to force this to go in the wrong way. And I did that for a while until I realized it didn't make any sense. And I finally was smart enough to flip it over. Here I'm still just fidgeting, trying to see exactly how this goes back into place.
It seems to click into place.
I'm gonna hit the switch. Are you guys ready? Keep my hands on, girl. Pick your afro because it's flat on one side, honey.
Okay. Y'all, I'm so scared.
But I'm about to hit the switch. So let's see what happens. Can I get a drum roll?
Okay, y'all.
Let's hope it don't fall out the sky. Let me get off this ladder. Cause baby,
Okay, so now you can see me.
All right, so I'm about to flip the switch. I'm super scared that something bad is gonna happen. I don't know what, but okay, let me just do it. A girl fixed it. Dust is flying everywhere, but your girl fixed it. Period, I fixed it. So, it's still loud, but it's much quieter than it was the first time. And now, I think I just have to put this piece back on. And I'll be done.
I think you just squeeze these and put them in here. I don't know how far up they go.
So, after all that struggle, I know you're gonna subscribe to my channel, leave me a comment, hit the thumbs up, and help me grow this channel. Like, what more do I have to do? Come on, y'all, subscribe. I will be back with another furniture flip later in the week, so be looking out for that. It's already completed, just has to be edited. And hopefully I will have some more interesting content coming your way soon. Please be on the lookout. Make sure you subscribe, hit the bell so that you will know when I post a new video so you can come watch it. Girl, watch my videos. Do you see what I have to go through? What more can I do? Girl, subscribe. Hit it like this. Go and subscribe, okay? Jesus. Anyway, I'm just being goofy, but seriously, if you could subscribe to my channel, I'd really appreciate it. Let me know what content you would like to see. Let me know how you enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you guys in the next one, which will be a furniture flip. Bye, y'all.